Chapter 3. Drainage System. Chapter 3. Drainage System. You have observed water flowing through the rivers, nalas, and even channels during rainy season which drain the excess water. Had these channels not been there, large-scale flooding would have occurred. Wherever channels are ill-defined or choked, flooding is a common phenomenon. The flow of water through well-defined channels is known as drainage, and the network of such channels is called a drainage system. The drainage pattern of an area is the outcome of the geological time period, nature and structure of rocks, topography, slope, amount of water flowing, and the periodicity of the flow. Do you have a river near your village or city? Have you ever been there for boating or bathing? Is it perennial, always with water, or ephemeral, water during rainy season, and dry, otherwise? Do you know that rivers flow in the same direction? You have studied about slopes in the other two textbooks of geography, NCERT, 2006, in this class. Can you, then, explain the reason for water flowing from one direction to the other? Why do the rivers originating from the Himalayas in the northern India and the Western Ghat in the southern India flow towards the east and discharge their waters in the Bay of Bengal? A river drains the water collected from a specific area, which is called its catchment area. Figure 3. 1. A river in the mountainous region. An area drained by a river and its tributaries is called a drainage basin. The boundary line separating one drainage basin from the other is known as the watershed. The catchments of large rivers are called river basins, while those of small rivulets and rills are often referred to as watersheds. There is, however, a slight difference between a river basin and a watershed. Watersheds are small in area, while the basins cover larger areas. Important drainage patterns. The drainage pattern resembling the branches of a tree is known as dendritic, the examples of which are the rivers of northern plain. When the rivers originate from a hill and flow in all directions, the drainage pattern is known as radial. The rivers originating from the Amarkantic range present a good example of it. When the primary tributaries of rivers flow parallel to each other and secondary tributaries join them at right angles, the pattern is known as trellis. When the rivers discharge their waters from all directions in a lake or depression, the pattern is known as centripetal. Find out some of the patterns in the topo sheet given in Chapter 5 of Practical Work in Geography Part 1, NCERT, 2006. Figure 3. 2. Major rivers of India. River basins and watersheds are marked by unity. What happens in one part of the basin or watershed directly affects the other parts and the unit as a whole. That is why they are accepted as the most appropriate micro, meso or macro planning regions. Indian drainage system may be divided on various bases. On the basis of discharge of water, orientations to the sea, it may be grouped into the Arabian Sea drainage and the Bay of Bengal drainage. They are separated from each other through the Delhi Ridge, the Aravallis and the Sahyadris water divide as shown by a line in Figure 3. 1. Nearly 77% of the drainage area consisting of the Ganga, the Brahmaputra, the Mahanadi, the Krishna, etc. is oriented towards the Bay of Bengal, while 23% comprising the Indus, the Narmada, the Tapi, the Mahi and the Periyar systems discharge their waters in the Arabian Sea. On the basis of the size of the watershed, the drainage basins of India are grouped into three categories. Major river basins with square km of catchment area. It includes 14 drainage basins such as the Ganga, the Brahmaputra, the Krishna, the Tapi, the Narmada, the Mahi, the Penner, the Sabarmati, the Barak, etc. Appendix 3. Medium river basins with catchment 1,000-20,000 square km incorporating 44 river basins such as the Kalindi, the Periyar, the Meghna, etc. Minor river basins with catchment area of less than 2,000 square km include fairly good number of rivers flowing in the area of low rainfall. If you look at the figure 3.1, you can see that many rivers have their sources in the Himalayas and discharge their waters either in the Bay of Bengal or in the Arabian Sea. Identify these rivers of North India. Large rivers flowing on the peninsular plateau have their origin in the Western Ghats and discharge their waters in the Bay of Bengal. Identify these rivers of the South India. The Narmada and Tapi are two large rivers which are exceptions. They, along with many small rivers, discharge their waters in the Arabian Sea. Name these rivers of the western coastal region from the Konkan to the Malabar coast. On the basis of the mode of origin, nature and characteristics, the Indian drainage may also be classified into the Himalayan drainage and the peninsular drainage. Although it has the problem of including the Chambal, the Betwa, the Sun, etc. which are much older in age and origin than other rivers that have their origin in the Himalayas, it is the most accepted basis of classification. Hence, this scheme has been followed in this book. Drainage Systems of India. Indian drainage system consists of a large number of small and big rivers. It is the outcome of the evolutionary process of the three major physiographic units and the nature and characteristics of precipitation. The Himalayan drainage. Figure 3. 3. Rapids. The Himalayan drainage system has evolved through a long geological history. It mainly includes the Ganga, the Indus, and the Brahmaputra river basins. Since these are fed both by melting of snow and precipitation, rivers of this system are perennial. These rivers pass through the giant gorges carved out by the erosional activity carried on simultaneously with the uplift of the Himalayas. Besides deep gorges, these rivers also form V-shaped valleys, rapids, and waterfalls in their mountainous course. While entering the plains, they form depositional features like flat valleys, oxbow lakes, floodplains, braided channels, and deltas near the river mouth. In the Himalayan reaches, the course of these rivers is highly tortuous, but over the plains they display a strong meandering tendency and shift their courses frequently. River Kosi, also known as the Tsaro of Bihar, has been notorious for frequently changing its course. The Kosi brings huge quantity of sediments from its upper reaches and deposits it in the plains. The course gets blocked, and consequently, the river changes its course. Why does the Kosi River bring such huge quantity of sediments from the upper reaches? Do you think that the discharge of the water in the rivers in general and the Kosi in particular remains the same, or does it fluctuate? When does the river course receive the maximum quantity of water? What are the positive and negative effects of flooding? Evolution of the Himalayan drainage. There are differences of opinion about the evolution of the Himalayan rivers. However, geologists believe that a mighty river called Shiwalik or Indo-Brahma traversed the entire longitudinal extent of the Himalaya from Assam to Punjab and onwards to Sindh, and finally discharged into the Gulf of Sindh near Lower Punjab during the Miocene period some 5-24 million years ago. See the table of geological time scale in Chapter 2 of Fundamentals of Physical Geography. NCERT, 2006. The remarkable continuity of the Shiwalik and its lacustrine origin and alluvial deposits consisting of sands, silt, clay, boulders and conglomerates support this viewpoint. It is opined that in due course of time Indo-Brahma River was dismembered into three main drainage systems. I. The Indus and its five tributaries in the western part. E. The Ganga and its Himalayan tributaries in the central part. And E. The stretch of the Brahmaputra in Assam and its Himalayan tributaries in the eastern part. The dismemberment was probably due to the Pleistocene upheaval in the western Himalayas, including the uplift of the Patwar Plateau, Delhi Ridge, which acted as the water divide between the Indus and Ganga drainage systems. Likewise, the downthrusting of the Malda Gap area between the Rajmahal Hills and the Meghalaya Plateau during the mid-Pleistocene period diverted the Ganga and the Brahmaputra systems to flow towards the Bay of Bengal. The river systems of the Himalayan drainage. The Himalayan drainage consists of several river systems, but the following are the major river systems. The Indus system. It is one of the largest river basins of the world, covering an area of 11,65,000 square km. In India it is 321,289 square km and a total length of 2,880 kilometers, in India 1,114 kilometers. The Indus, also known as the Sindhu, is the westernmost of the Himalayan rivers in India. It originates from a glacier near Bakar Chu, 31 degrees 15 N latitude and 81 degrees 40 E longitude, in the Tibetan region at an altitude of 4,164 meters in the Kailash mountain range. In Tibet, it is known as Tsingi Kamban, or Lion's Mouth. After flowing in the northwest direction between the Ladakh and Zaskar ranges, it passes through Ladakh and Baltistan. It cuts across the Ladakh range, forming a spectacular gorge near Gilgit in Jammu and Kashmir. It enters into Pakistan near Chiller in the Dardistan region. Find out the area known as Dardistan. The Indus receives a number of Himalayan tributaries such as the Shyok, the Gilgit, the Zaskar, the Hunza, the Nubra, the Shigar, the Gasting and the Dross. It finally emerges out of the hills near Attock, where it receives the Kabul River on its right bank. The other important tributaries joining the right bank of the Indus are the Karam, the Tochi, the Gomal, the Vibo and the Sangar. They all originate in the Sulaiman Ranges. The river flows southward and receives Panjnad, a little above Mithankot. The Panjnad is the name given to the five rivers of Punjab, namely the Satluj, the Bees, the Ravi, the Chenab and the Jhelum. It finally discharges into the Arabian Sea, east of Karachi. The Indus flows in India only through the Leh district in Jammu and Kashmir. The Jhelum, an important tributary of the Indus, rises from a spring at Varanagh situated at the foot of the Pir Panjal in the southeastern part of the Valley of Kashmir. It flows through Srinagar and the Wooler Lake before entering Pakistan through a deep narrow gorge. It joins the Chenab near Jhang in Pakistan. The Chenab is the largest tributary of the Indus. It is formed by two streams, the Chandra and the Bagha, which join at Tandi near Keelong in Himachal Pradesh. Hence, it is also known as Chandrabagha. The river flows for 1,180 kilometers before entering into Pakistan. The Ravi is another important tributary of the Indus. It rises west of the Rohtang Pass in the Kulu Hills of Himachal Pradesh and flows through the Chamba Valley of the state. Before entering Pakistan and joining the Chenab near Sarai Sidhu, it drains the area lying between the southeastern part of the Pir Panjal and the Dauladhar Ranges. The Bees is another important tributary of the Indus, originating from the Bees Kund near the Rohtang Pass at an elevation of 4,000 meters above the mean sea level. The river flows through the Kulu Valley and forms gorges at Kadi and Largi in the Dauladhar Range. It enters the Punjab Plains where it meets the Satluj near Harikay. The Satluj originates in the Rakas Lake near Mansarovar at an altitude of 4,555 meters in Tibet where it is known as Langchen Kambab. It flows almost parallel to the Indus for about 400 kilometers before entering India and comes out of a gorge at Rupar. It passes through the Shipkila on the Himalayan ranges and enters the Punjab Plains. It is an antecedent river. It is a very important tributary as it feeds the canal system of the Bokra-Nangal project. The Ganga system. The Ganga is the most important river of India both from the point of view of its basin and cultural significance. It rises in the Gangotri Glacier near Gaumuk 3,900 meters in the Uttarkashi district of Uttarakhand. Here, it is known as the Bhagirathi. It cuts through the central and the lesser Himalayas in narrow gorges. At Devprayag, the Bhagirathi meets the Alananda. Hereafter, it is known as the Ganga. The Alananda has its source in the Satopanth Glacier above Badrinath. The Alananda consists of the Dali and the Vishnu Ganga which meet at Joshimath or Vishnu Prayag. The other tributaries of Alananda such as the Pindar joins it at Karna Prayag while Mandakini or Kali Ganga meets it at Rudra Prayag. The Ganga enters the plains at Haridwar. From here, it flows first to the south, then to the southeast and east before splitting into two distributaries, namely the Bhagirathi and the Hugli. The river has a length of 2,525 kilometers. It is shared by Uttarakhand, 110 kilometers, and Uttar Pradesh, 1,450 kilometers, Bihar, 445 kilometers, and West Bengal, 520 kilometers. The Ganga Basin covers about 8.6 lakh square km area in India alone. The Ganga River system is the largest in India having a number of perennial and non-perennial rivers originating in the Himalayas in the north and the peninsula in the south, respectively. The Sun is its major right bank tributary. The important left bank tributaries are the Ramganga, the Gomati, the Ghaggara, the Gandak, the Kosi and the Mahananda. The river finally discharges itself into the Bay of Bengal near the Sagar Island. The Yamuna, the westernmost and the longest tributary of the Ganga, has its source in the Yamunotri Glacier on the western slopes of Bandarpanch Range, 6,316 kilometers. It joins the Ganga at Prayag, Allahabad. It is joined by the Chambal, the Sindh, the Betwa and the Ken on its right bank which originates from the peninsular plateau while the Hindon, the Rhind, the Sengar, the Varuna, etc. join it on its left bank. Much of its water feeds the western and eastern Yamuna and the Agra canals for irrigation purposes. Name the states which are drained by the river Yamuna. The Chambal rises near Mhow in the Malwa Plateau of Madhya Pradesh and flows northwards through a gorge upwards of Kota in Rajasthan, where the Gandhisagar Dam has been constructed. From Kota, it traverses down to Bundi, Sawai Madhapur and Dholpur, and finally joins the Yamuna. The Chambal is famous for its badland topography called the Chambal Ravines. The Gandak comprises two streams, namely Kaligandak and Trishulganga. It rises in the Nepal Himalayas between the Daulagiri and Mount Everest and drains the central part of Nepal. It enters the Ganga Plain in Champaran district of Bihar and joins the Ganga at Sonpur near Patna. The Ghaggara originates in the glaciers of Mapchachungo. After collecting the waters of its tributaries, Tila, Seti and Beri, it comes out of the mountain, cutting a deep gorge at Shishapani. The river Sarda, Kali or Kali Ganga, joins it in the plain before it finally meets the Ganga at Chapra. The Kosi is an antecedent river with its source to the north of Mount Everest in Tibet, where its main stream Arun rises. After crossing the central Himalayas in Nepal, it is joined by the Sun Kosi from the west and the Tamur Kosi from the east. It forms Sapt Kosi after uniting with the river Arun. The Ramganga is comparatively a small river rising in the Garhwal Hills near Gersain. It changes its course direction after crossing the Shiwalik and enters into the plains of Uttar Pradesh near Najibabad. Finally, it joins the Ganga near Kanauj. The Damodar occupies the eastern margins of the Chotanagpur Plateau where it flows through a rift valley and finally joins the Hugli. The Barakar is its main tributary. Once known as the Tsaro of Bengal, the Damodar has been now tamed by the Damodar Valley Corporation, a multi-purpose project. The Sarda or Sariu River rises in the Milam Glacier in the Nepal Himalayas where it is known as the Gorganga. Along the Indo-Nepal border, it is called Kali or Chak, where it joins the Gagara. The Mahananda is another important tributary of the Ganga rising in the Darjeeling Hills. It joins the Ganga as its last left bank tributary in West Bengal. The Sun is a large south bank tributary of the Ganga, originating in the Amarkantik Plateau. After forming a series of waterfalls at the edge of the plateau, it reaches Ara, west of Patna, to join the Ganga. The Brahmaputra system. The Brahmaputra, one of the largest rivers of the world, has its origin in the Chamayungdung Glacier of the Kailash Range near the Mansarovar Lake. From here, it traverses eastward longitudinally for a distance of nearly 1,200 kilometers in a dry and flat region of southern Tibet, where it is known as the Tsangpo, which means the purifier. The Rango Tsangpo is the major right bank tributary of this river in Tibet. It emerges as a turbulent and dynamic river after carving out a deep gorge in the central Himalayas near Namcha Barwa, 7,755 meters. The river emerges from the foothills under the name of Siangwar Dehang. It enters India west of Sadia town in Arunachal Pradesh. Flowing southwest, it receives its main left bank tributaries, Biz, Dibang or Sikang and Lohit. Thereafter, it is known as the Brahmaputra. The Brahmaputra receives numerous tributaries in its 750 kilometers long journey through the Assam Valley. Its major left the Buri Dying and Donsari, south, whereas the important right bank tributaries are the Sabansiri, Kameng, Manas and Sankosh. The Sabansiri, which has its origin in Tibet, is an antecedent river. The Brahmaputra enters into Bangladesh near Dubri and flows southward. In Bangladesh, the Tista joins it on its right bank from where the river is known as the Yamuna. It finally merges with the river Padma, which falls in the Bay of Bengal. The Brahmaputra is well known for floods, channel shifting and bank erosion. This is due to the fact that most of its tributaries are large, and bring large quantity of sediments owing to heavy rainfall in its catchment area. The Peninsular Drainage System. The Peninsular Drainage System is older than the Himalayan one. This is evident from the broad, largely graded shallow valleys, and the maturity of the rivers. The Western Ghats running close to the western coast act as the water divide between the major peninsular rivers, discharging their water in the Bay of Bengal and as small rivulets joining the Arabian Sea. Most of the major peninsular rivers except Narmada and Tapi flow from west to east. The Chambal, the Sindh, the Betwa, the Ken, the Sun, originating in the northern part of the peninsula belong to the Ganga River system. The other major river systems of the peninsular drainage are, the Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna and the Kaveri. Peninsular rivers are characterized by fixed course, absence of meanders and non-perennial flow of water. The Narmada and the Tapi which flow through the Rift Valley are, however, exceptions. The evolution of peninsular drainage system. Three major geological events in the distant past have shaped the present drainage systems of peninsular India. I. Subsidence of the western flank of the peninsula leading to its submergence below the sea during the early tertiary period. Generally, it has disturbed the symmetrical plan of the river on either side of the original watershed. E. Upheaval of the Himalayas when the northern flank of the peninsular block was subjected to subsidence and the consequent trough faulting. The Narmada and the Tapi flow in trough faults and fill the original cracks with their detritus materials. Hence, there is a lack of alluvial and deltaic deposits in these rivers. E. Slight tilting of the peninsular block from northwest to the southeastern direction gave orientation to the entire drainage system towards the Bay of Bengal during the same period. River systems of the peninsular drainage. There are a large number of river systems in the peninsular drainage. A brief account of the major peninsular river systems is given below. The Mahanadi rises near Sihawa in Raipur district of Chhattisgarh and runs through Odisha to discharge its water into the Bay of Bengal. It is 851 kilometers long and its catchment area spreads over 1.42 lakh square km. Some navigation is carried on in the lower course of this river. 53% of the drainage basin of this river lies in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, while 47% lies in Odisha. The Godavari is the largest peninsular river system. It is also called the Dakshin Ganga. It rises in the Nasik district of Maharashtra and discharges its water into the Bay of Bengal. Its tributaries run through the states of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. It is 1,465 kilometers long with a catchment area spreading over 3.13 lakh square km. 49% of this lies in Maharashtra, 20% in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, and the rest in Andhra Pradesh. The Penganga, the Indravati, the Pranhita, and the Mandra are its principal tributaries. The Godavari is subjected to heavy floods in its lower reaches to the south of Polavaram, where it forms a picturesque gorge. It is navigable only in the deltaic stretch. The river after Rajahmundry splits into several branches forming a large delta. The Krishna is the second largest east flowing peninsular river which rises near Mahabaleshwar in Sahyadri. Its total length is 1,401 kilometers. The Koyna, the Tungbhadra and the Bhima are its major tributaries. Of the total catchment area of the Krishna, 27% lies in Maharashtra, 44% in Karnataka and 29% in Andhra Pradesh. The Kaveri rises in Brahmagiri Hills, 1,341 meters, of Kogadu district in Karnataka. Its length is 800 kilometers and it drains an area of 81,155 square km. Since the upper catchment area receives rainfall during the southwest monsoon season, summer, and the lower part during the northeast monsoon season, winter, the river carries water throughout the year with comparatively less fluctuation than the other peninsular rivers. About 3% of the Kaveri Basin falls in Kerala, 41% in Karnataka and 56% in Tamil Nadu. Its important tributaries are the Kabini, the Bhavani and the Amravati. The Narmada originates on the western flank of the Amarkantik Plateau at a height of about 1,057 meters. Flowing in a rift valley between the Satpura in the south and the Vindhyan Range in the north, it forms a picturesque gorge in marble rocks and Dwandar waterfall near Jabalpur. After flowing a distance of about 1,312 kilometers, it meets the Arabian Sea south of Baruch, forming a broad 27 kilometers long estuary. Its catchment area is about 98,796 square km. The Sardar Sarovar project has been constructed on this river. The Tapi is the other important westward flowing river. It originates from Multai in the Batul district of Madhya Pradesh. It is 724 kilometers long and drains an area of 65,145 square km. Nearly 79% of its basin lies in Maharashtra, 15% in Madhya Pradesh and the remaining 6% in Gujarat. Luni is the largest river system of Rajasthan, west of Aravali. It originates near Pushkar in two branches, i.e., the Saraswati and the Sabarmati, which join with each other at Govindgarh. From here, the river comes out of Aravali and is known as Luni. It flows towards the west till Telwara and then takes a southwest direction to join the Ran of Kutchich. The entire river system is ephemeral. Smaller rivers flowing towards the west. The rivers flowing towards the Arabian Sea have short courses. Why do they have short courses? Find out the smaller rivers of Gujarat. The Shetruni Ji is one such river which rises near Dalkawa in Amreli district. The Bhadra originates near Anioli village in Raikot district. The Dadar rises near Gantar village in Panchmahal district. Sabarmati and Mahi are the two famous rivers of Gujarat. Find out the places of confluence of these rivers. Find out some important west flowing rivers of Maharashtra. The Vaitarna rises from the Trimbak Hills in Nasik district at an elevation of 670 meters. The Kalanadi rises from Belgaum district and falls in the Karwar Bay. The source of Bedti River lies in Hubli Dharwar and traverses a course of 161 kilometers. The Sharavati is another important river in Karnataka flowing towards the west. The Sharavati originates in Shimoga district of Karnataka and drains a catchment area of 2,209 square km. Find out the name of the river on which the Gersapa, Jog, fall is found. Goa has two important rivers which can be mentioned here. One is Mandovi and the other is Juari. You can locate. Kerala has a narrow coastline. The longest river of Kerala, Bharathapuzha, rises near Annamalai Hills. It is also known as Ponani. It drains an area of 5,397 square km. Compare its catchment area with that of the Sharavati River of Karnataka. The Periyar is the second largest river of Kerala. Its catchment area is 5,243 square km. You can see that there is a marginal difference in the catchment area of the Bharathapuzha and the Periyar rivers. Another river of Kerala worth mentioning is the Pamba River, which falls in the Vemmalbanad Lake after traversing a course of 177 kilometers. Small rivers flowing towards the east. There are a large number of rivers flowing towards the east along with their tributaries. Can you name some of these rivers? There are small rivers which join the Bay of Bengal. Though small, these are important in their own right. The Sabarnrekha, the Baitarni, the Brahmani, the Vamsadhara, the Penner, the Palar and the Vaigai are important rivers. Find out these rivers from the atlas. Table 3. 1. Comparison between the Himalayan and the Peninsular River. River regimes. Do you know that the quantity of water flowing in a river channel is not the same throughout the year? It varies from season to season. In which season do you expect the maximum flow in Ganga and Kaveri? The pattern of flow of water in a river channel over a year is known as its regime. The North Indian rivers originating from the Himalayas are perennial as they are fed by glaciers through snow melt and also receive rainfall water during rainy season. The rivers of South India do not originate from glaciers and their flow pattern witnesses fluctuations. The flow increases considerably during monsoon rains. Thus, the regime of the rivers of South India is controlled by rainfall, which also varies from one part of the peninsular plateau to the other. The discharge is the volume of water flowing in a river measured over time. It is measured either in cusex cubic feet per second or cumex cubic meters per second. The Ganga has its minimum flow during the January-June period. The maximum flow is attained either in August or in September. After September, there is a steady fall in the flow. The river, thus, has a monsoon regime during the rainy season. There are striking differences in the river regimes in the eastern and the western parts of the Ganga basin. The Ganga maintains a sizable flow in the early part of summer due to snow melt before the monsoon rains begin. The mean maximum discharge of the Ganga at Farakka is about 55,000 cusecs, while the mean minimum is only 1,300 cusecs. What factors are responsible for such a large difference? The two peninsular rivers display interesting differences in their regimes compared to the Himalayan rivers. The Narmada has a very low volume of discharge from January to July, but it suddenly rises in August when the maximum flow is attained. The fall in October is as spectacular as the rise in August. The flow of water in the Narmada, as recorded at Garudeshwar, shows that the maximum flow is of the order of 2,300 cusecs, while the minimum flow is only 15 cusecs. The Godavari has the minimum discharge in May, and the maximum in July-August. After August, there is a sharp fall in water flow, although the volume of flow in October and November is higher than that in any of the months from January to May. The mean maximum discharge of the Godavari at Polavaram is 3,200 cusecs, while the mean minimum flow is only 50 cusecs. These figures give an idea of the regime of the river. Extent of usability of river water. The rivers of India carry huge volumes of water per year, but it is unevenly distributed both in time and space. There are perennial rivers carrying water throughout the year, while the non-perennial rivers have very little water during the dry season. During the rainy season, much of the water is wasted in floods and flows down to the sea. Similarly, when there is a flood in one part of the country, the other area suffers from drought. Why does this happen? Is it the problem of availability of water resource or that of its management? Can you suggest some measures to mitigate the problems of floods and droughts simultaneously occurring in different parts of the country? See Chapter 7 of the book. Can these problems be solved or minimized by transferring the surplus water from one basin to the water deficit basins? Do we have some schemes of interbasin linkage? Teachers may explain the following examples. Periyar Diversion Scheme. Indira Gandhi Canal Project. Karnool Kadapa Canal. Bees Satluj Link Canal. Ganga Kaveri Link Canal. Have you read in the newspapers about the linking of rivers? Do you think that digging a canal is enough to transfer water from the Ganga basin to the peninsular river? What is the major problem? Consult chapter 2 of this book and find out the difficulties posed by the unevenness of the terrain. How can the water be lifted from the plain area to the plateau area? Is there sufficient surplus water in the North Indian rivers which can be transferred on a regular basis? Organize a debate on the whole issue and prepare a write-up. How do you rank the following problems in using river water? I. No availability in sufficient quantity. E. River water pollution. E. Load of silt in the river water. IV. Uneven seasonal flow of water. V. River water disputes between states. V. Shrinking of channels due to the extension of settlements towards the Thalweg. Why are the rivers polluted? Have you seen the dirty waters of cities entering into the rivers? Where do the industrial effluents and wastes get disposed of? Most of the cremation grounds are on the banks of rivers and the dead bodies are sometimes thrown in the rivers. On the occasion of some festivals, the flowers and statues are immersed in the rivers. Large-scale bathing and washing of clothes also pollute river waters. How can the rivers be made pollution-free? Have you read about Ganga Action Plan, or about a campaign for cleaning the Yamuna at Delhi? Collect materials on schemes for making rivers pollution-free and organize the materials in a write-up. Exercises. 1. Choose the right answer from the four alternatives given below. I. Which one of the following rivers was known as the Tsaro of Bengal? At the Gandak, C. The Kosi. B. The Sun, D. The Damodar. E. Which one of the following rivers has the largest river basin in India? At the Indus, C. The Ganga. B. The Brahmaputra, D. The Krishna. E. Which one of the following rivers is not included in Panchnad? At the Ravi, C. The Indus. B. The Chenab, D. The Jhelum. IV. Which one of the following rivers flows in a rift valley? At the Sun, C. The Yamuna. B. The Narmada, D. The Luni. B. Which one of the following is the place of confluence of the Alananda and the Bhagirathi? At Bishnu Prayag, C. Karan Prayag. B. Rudra Prayag, D. Deva Prayag. 2. State the differences between the following. I. River basin and watershed. E. Dendritic and trellis drainage pattern. E. Radial and centripetal drainage pattern. IV. Delta and estuary. 3. Answer the following questions in about 30 words. I. What are the socio-economic advantages of interlinking of rivers in India? E. Write 3 characteristics of the peninsular river. 4. Answer the following questions in not more than 125 words. I. What are the important characteristic features of North Indian rivers? How are these different from peninsular rivers? E. Suppose you are traveling from Haridwar to Siliguri along the foothills of the Himalayas. Name the important rivers you will come across. Describe the characteristics of any one of them. Project, activity. Study the Appendix 3 and answer the following questions. I. Which river has the largest